strangely enough. Still Adrian.
Oh, the Orc. My bad, my bad. The Orc.
No thrower, also.
Yeah. So we want to...
Let's check the levels up. Lupak has two skills, however, both of them are loner. And Spartacus does have that guard. Even said, Spartacus does have that guard.
So Spartacus, the Italian fella.
Five streamers cast in this same game.
Oh baby.
Isn't that crazy?
Who's the fifth?
I don't know. I just heard Multiminded say we're up to five streamers. So that would be you, me, Jimmy. Who's this? Who's there? Like Lupex is streaming his own. Maybe Cobra is streaming it.
Looks like it. It's alright, Bucky. We'll be the best. We're the A team.
We are the A team.
When Nithios watches one of our replays, he'll be like, these guys are good. We're going to have to get them. Except for that woman in the background. We'll get rid of her.
Let's get her. Yeah.
I jest. She came into the stream today and berated me.
I don't know if she will be arriving today. She is a bit, like, you know, she does not know what internet is, like how cruel the internet can be.
She
does not like it.
Soon.
So yeah, like. Also, I saw a comment down there today that some of your guys calling me a moron.
Ooh, who was it?
Imagine that, Fash.
Who was it?
Some crust guy.
Ah, Crimson.
Yeah, I believe I have seen myself being called a moron. And Fash, you didn't say anything. You should have said no. He's not a moron. He's an idiot. That would have been nice of you.
I let my chat do what they want. There's no rules. If you like, I think censorship on the internet is a terrible idea. And if someone has an opinion, they should be able to say it. And they don't need some overlord trying to correct them. With the exception of Tri, who I will always pick a fight with for no reason.
I completely agree with that. Censorship allowed, but if someone, yeah. Like people just say, you're not a man until someone calls you a moron. I completely agree with that. But still, Fash, you could have said, nah, moron could be an idiot. Like, you know, idiot is a lower class.
Well, that's one of his moderators. I think his name was the Crimson Crust or something. And you can...
I'm not the boss of other people.
You can hear the venom in her voice, right?
Just one second. Because he was there, he saw everything. And you can just tell him so he can stick it in deep tonight to himself.
Well, you know? I've already got an opinion. I like Bucky.
You can hear the venom in her voice, right?
That was
I don't care what other people think.
That's your opinion.
I don't give a fuck about that guy, but calling you a moron and saying those bad things to me, that was really, really rude. And I'm not going to be here anymore. Don't worry.
So, you heard it here.
Well, there you go, quite upset.
Yeah. I know, I'm telling you.
Everyone's entitled to their own opinion.
Exactly, everyone is entitled to
I'm not going
to
tell him he's wrong if that's what he thinks. But I think it's just because he's American, might not have heard of Serbian before. People are calling me morons now, it hurts my feelings.
In any case, imagine that. I believe the game is about to start, right? After all this time, I believe that they're finally ready. Or who's receiving? Are we watching the game from the Orcs' point of view or from Elves' point of view?
Let's watch it from the Orcs.
From the Orcs' point of view, yeah. I'm looking at
the default.
But still, Flash, the weather is fine. I still think I meant, a bit more to you than, to defend me, to say I'm like some idiot. Seriously, my feelings are hurt. Like, I cannot filter his, but you should have said something. Right.
Words on the internet, Bucky. I just don't even care. Like, don't even care.
I know. I felt, was thinking, maybe deep down, Fash is a human being, but yeah, no.
In real life, for sure. If someone picked a fight with you at the bar, I'd be like, oi, oi mate, you want to go, do you? But on the internet, it's just not even worth it. Don't post on forums. Don't argue on Reddit. Not worth my time. Don't even talk in chat with my opponents. I got berated because there was a guy being friendly in chat, and chat said to me, "Hey, why don't you talk back to him?" I just don't even bother.
Yeah, why would you? I know. It's internet.
Yep. Right, I don't love you, Bucky.
Elves are actually receiving. Do you believe they chose to receive, or the orcs forced them? Can we see that somewhere?
I don't think so.
Now, the two loners might be... Lou is down a blitzer, isn't he?
He is.
Yeah, he has only two blitzers, only two blocks on the team.
Orcs, I think he'll really struggle this game. Contingent. And I think
he might, depending on how Spartaco plays. I have heard good things about Spartaco from some sources. Have you heard something similar?
Nothing at all. I naturally watched his last match, right? But it wasn't memorable enough. But similarly, I don't remember most matches. It looks like he's just willing to dodge away on the line and not commit to any blocks at all, so he's looking to keep his elves alive. And I think if Spartaco did get the level on his blitzer, knowing he's playing an elf next, probably should have taken Mighty Blow, I think. I don't think he's going to be struggling for strength. However, sliding in a blitzer somewhere is useful.
I do not believe that guard is going to... Well, you know what? The guard is kind of useful if you manage to get, to force the elves to give away a hit on the ball. Then that guard might make one dice into a two dice.
Yeah, absolutely. There will be situations.
Other than that, you are... Exactly. But other than that, you are correct. The elves, as you can see, they're spreading out. They're not going to let that guard to be relevant in this game. I mean, that's their plan, at least.
Sure.
So far, Lupak is setting up a lot of tackle zones all around the pitch. Like, keeping his options open. He can swing by either side if Orc overcommits.
It's still super early. He'll be planning to score on turn 8. And it does look like he's saving his blitz.
Yeah, he's saving his blitz for the next turn. Like, that could be an actual mechanic. Like, save up a blitz and have, like, a half or a quarter of a blitz, and then, you know, if you save up enough, you can do two blitzes in a turn.
That'd be OP.
Obviously, only when you have the ball. When you don't have the ball, you don't have that option.
OP.
That could be interesting. Could be interesting.
Screening
and he rolled a one on the first dodge. Check that out. Well, now the ball is... would you tag the ball, Fash? Right about now. Would you tag the ball?
Just mark it with a lineman? It's a big commitment.
Mark it with a blitzer, basically.
Yeah, you'd have someone out of position. If you weren't willing to make the go for it, you'd be giving a free hit.
Yeah, go for it. Go for it to mark him and to either induce a blitz. He'll definitely blitz, I believe. Like, you're not going to use his one reroll and dodge in the way. And that means he ain't blitzing anywhere, and that means that you have a player up there. I believe I would mark the ball right.
Get through the
there.
Screen? Yeah, I think that's fun. I think even blitzing
hit
with
this
the...
dude off.
Yeah.
Hit this not a people loner and just tag him. I would base hold him fucking else. That's what I do with dwarves. And that's what
it's
the
Spartaco
seems to be doing. It's happening. Like, this is the problem with the position that the Lupak that with spreading of elves. You get every single elf based. That might be a problem.
He will have to be careful with number 4 lineman Oxpires to not get blitzed and surfed.
Well, he can't really. There's a threat of the witch, so he cannot really, you know, position a guy next to it.
Indeed.
That's good. This means that one black orc will be able to tag, or even a lineman will be able to tag both of these elves. I really like the blitz direction from this blitzer, right?
Yeah, absolutely. You didn't think about the black orc on the blitzer. On the elf blitzer.
Even if that was a push, he had a follow-up lock with the black orc. So that was a good play. If your guys are looking for good plays, this was one of them. Tag the witch. Why not? 1-36. Lost me a couple of games. Tag everyone. And now Lupak has to roll.
It's going to be a lot of dice.
It is going to be a lot of deaths. He has the witch, like, that's the safest dodge away. He does have a free blitzer up there. Surely he's going to tag these two on the floor. I'm wondering, will he use a lineman or a blitzer? A guard blitzer sounds best for the job.
I might have kept the blitzer in the backfield just in case Lude decides to potato somewhere. He doesn't have anyone to really potato with, so not such an issue. Also, the blitzer position is already in two tackle zones, so the deep field blitzer comes to stand adjacent to the ball carrier, and the blitzer not next to the ball carrier makes a two-die block on the orc blitzer that's touching the ball, and that's a free block to free the ball carrier. Then a blitz could come elsewhere to cause trouble, make some space.
I would go for it. He does have two rerolls, though. That's something I just noticed.
It is a risk, but I think it's a risk that was worth it. Because otherwise, there's just no pressure at all. You're not dictating the blitz. You're not really controlling anything. There's lots of dodges, but... like, I wouldn't be surprised if the number 9 lineman received the ball and made a potato. Because it is a big commitment, and the Blackhawks are very slow.
But still, the Orcs, he does have a bit of a safety. Well, he doesn't. Like, his only safety is the number 10 lineman, right? Or all the way. That's like the only free Orc currently, if all of the others stand up. So, still, this is a tough situation for Lubeck. I hate to be in this situation as Elves, especially the Elves with two rerolls. Like, it can work. It can work really good if you make all of them dodges. Like, you can get Orcs really seriously out of position. But what if you fail? We need to see. So, good idea is to get that blitzer down, hit him off, and then use a blitz for somewhere else. But where would your blitz go?
I'd blitz the number 2 blitzer. And on a power, think about the potato with number 9 lineman. So I'd have the Witch Dodge out to assist for the block in the midfield to clear the ball carrier. Blitz from the number 2 blitzer downfield. Hit the Orc number 2 blitzer.
Freeze up to number 9 lineman. And then where does that lineman and the ball go after that?
Nowhere great.
You cannot really dodge out these Elves, because if you position the problem is he needs to get the ball safe. And the only way where the ball can be safe-ish is way in the back.
Yeah, well, that is the other option if the potato just seems too terrible. If everyone stands up and you're down
right.
The...
here comes the blitz. Here comes the blitz. It frees up the ball. That's an orc hit. That would be a break on an armor 8 target. Shame that he cannot get one more square to enable the block.
He can.
Obviously not worth the GFI.
That's a big risk.
We all know it. Yeah, we all know that it's not. Alright, the loner being sacrificial there. The other one also being sacrificial. That's what you have to do.
It could be really costly.
You have to sacrifice a couple of pieces. Where is the ball going? That's what I'm interested in. Where is the ball going?
I think you're right. Just retreating back to the corner. He doesn't want to score on turn 2, 3, or 4. And doing a potato would sort of mean he would have to.
Well, now he does have an issue with the number 2 blitzer. Number 2 orc blitzer. That guy can dodge and do a 1 dice quite easily if he fails the dodge.
Sure. I think number 3 blitzer will be dodging out.
If he fails the dodge.
It'll be a mandatory reroll. And if it happens, Barco's done his job.
Exactly. All right. Lupak is safe. The ball is safe for one more turn. And we get a break. Only a stun, though. Only a stun. That could swing the game heavily if that was a knockdown, like knockout or plus.
Oh, absolutely.
So far, Lupak is rolling well. No, he got a 1 in the first turn, so I believe he's entitled a bit. All right. That is the end of the turn. The Black Horse get to hit.
Right, when is one was a final action?
It did not. Like, the worst time to get the 1 and 9 would be with the block with the number 9 liner, right?
Definitely.
That would be a lot worse. Right, he did incur, what? We have 4 potential blocks, right?
Yep.
4 blocks he did incur. However, the orcs need to position down there. Yeah, the elves can outrun them. If, for example, these black orcs fail in their actions, everything can happen. Fast, tell me, would you do a 50% dodge to hit the ball carrier right about now? There is a black orc angling.
And a go for it. I don't think so. Not on turn 2.
Six blocks with blitz, says Sid. Six. Oh, right. No, that's the guy stood up. So 1, 2, 3, 4 blocks. 5 blocks with a blitz. Not 6. This guy just stood up, right?
Yeah. Number 9 line.
Exactly. So yeah, 5 blocks. That can be something. Those can also be pushes. These black orcs do not have block. The only one block with block is the guard blitzer. So it is not that hard as it, like, not that bad as it looks like. But that's what happens when you fail the rolls. He would happily dodge out those elves too. I believe the Spartacoon needs to pull back this blitzer, number 4 blitzer, right?
On I think the so. I right think flank. Number 10 lineman might even come with him.
Exactly. Those two can be useful down there because these elves, if something bad happens to the number 5 black orc all the way on the left flank, elves have a clean way through.
Yeah, definitely. And the black orcs in the center, you know, towards the witch elf. If he does make a breakaway, they're not going to go. They're not going to anywhere for 3 or 4 turns.
Well, they want to go down there if they can. All right, the first block is this. I was thinking, what will he do as the first block? Like, either a blitz or hit with the number 11 lineman down there next to the guard guy.
Probably 11 lineman for a stumble. I think it would look for maybe even the follow up from the number 10 if it's a push.
Exactly. Yeah, for the stumble and then yeah, follow up for him. Hit them onto the guard guy. However, you want to keep at least 2 guys so that guard actually pays off, like actually does something.
It's been a fierce debate in chat about the value of Mighty Blow versus Guard. Arguments for the Mighty Blow
I would prefer Mighty Blow. I would definitely prefer Mighty Blow in this match.
Against an elf, let's say they pick up, you know, they have one witch elf with dodge. Guard inside a cage means that you're not as threatened. Later on, maybe against a wood elf. Not as scared about the dancer leaps. Like, there's a lot of validity to what Guard can bring.
Against wood elf is...
As well as the dwarf heavy matter. Like, I think Guard is fine the more that I think about it.
Right, so he wants to free up this lineman, actually, does he? Yep. This is like the first successful block of the orcs, right?
This turn.
And the first block.
Oh, man.
Oh, my God. He is dead. He's a loner, so that does not matter, but he is dead fashion. We have seen Blood Bowl! Ah!
One less dwarf to deal with. Like, even though it's a liner, it's now down to 10. That's just a huge
that
relief.
That is a dead elf. That Lone. We like to now we need to see a dead orc. A death. We are you not entertained, right? Come on, Fash, you can do it. You can do the voice. Come on.
Are you not entertained? Is that
there
it?
There we have it. You know, the clap. Cue the clap.
Thank you, I'm here all night.
Until he falls asleep.
Well.
Alright. Are you still in the World Cup? Yes, I am. At least until tomorrow's game. Maybe.
Nah, you got it covered.
I have orcs.
I've made an orc team with a single guard blitzer.
I believe I'm playing against the same team, like similar team that Lupek is playing against, right?
Yeah.
The guy has 3 blitzers. How many blitzers does this guy have? 3, 2. 4. My guy has 3 blitzers and 4 black orcs. It has 3 rerolls though.
Right. Oh, yeah,
it's getting hard.
I've replicated the orcs team that you're playing against for any practicing you want to do later.
Right, we can. Well, I do not know if we can like do it tonight. Well, you would have to do it tonight, in fact. Because tomorrow is the game. I kind of wanted to practice Rocket League. I wanted to go through that training and tutorial.
Oh, fair enough.
kind of wanted to do that. Like, I just got the game, I want to get good so I can beat, you know, so I can beat Squirrel, do that.
It'll be a lot of practice.
Yeah. Alright. Alright, Lupa has a plan. Lupak has a plan. Let's check it out. What would you do now? Would you go down the left flank, which is obviously exposed? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. He will need to do some GFIs to get safe, right? Like at least one.
I think it might be a sacrifice to the Black Orc.
Well,
maybe it is double go for it. And then he's on the sideline.
Thought you loved me. Oh, right, Genesis, sorry about that. I cannot even practice the Rocket League. After 2 World Cup matches, I'm playing in the Legion League. So, yeah. Maybe after that, we'll practice it. We'll, like, prolong the stream and practice the Rocket League. We'll see. But yeah, Legion League match after the World Cup matches. Fash, what's the idea here? Double go for it?
It has to be. It has to be double go for it. Or even a single, maybe.
The double go for it.
It might just be
a double go for it, he's still not safe. Like, the Black Orc blocks him off, and the Blitzer dodges in and hits him. If he does not move the number 2 Blitzer, who's currently with the Witch Elf there, if he does not dodge him out, he is looking at a dice at the ball if he goes down the left flank.
Well, if his plan is to make the go for it, he's going to make those first and then attempt the extra dodges to maybe double mark the Black Orc. Or a man...
Double marking the Black Orc doesn't do anything. He needs one more guy to screen. He needs one more guy behind this loner. Like, he needs to make a sideline cage, basically.
Well, the number 6 lineman, Thor, would go 3+, 2+, 2+. And stand adjacent to the down blitzer.
You
I think
that
would be a game.
3 pluses are not really reliable. He's going to...
Definitely
if he wants to make a... Number 2, Richard Steele, right? He needs to make a sideline cage. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. That makes a one go for it and one dodge to be as safest as you can. I believe that's like 2 rolls to get decent and safe. Anything else, Fash? Anything I'm missing? Anything better than 2 rolls to get the sideline cage?
It's still more dice pretty early. That could be pretty costly.
Well, that's 2 pluses, right? And he has no other way of making the ball safe. Not that I see. He does not like better odds than that, that is. Alright. Well, he could place like that blitzer over there, not even make a go for it, right? Nope. Dice. This 1 in 36 would be catastrophic right about
it's
there.
It's catastrophic.
It is catastrophic. Can he get... Luckily, I do not believe he can get surfed here. No, actually, he could.
He definitely can. Absolutely.
He could. Like, but it would require some dodges and or GFIs. Right?
Yes. But look at one die from the Blitz is going to be the most likely play. The surf would just be so punishing, I think it may even be worth it.
Alright, so what we need a POW, if we want the surf to happen, we would need a POW on the loner, right?
Definitely.
Then a dodge from the number 11 lineman, and then a one dice blitz.
It's happening.
Let's see
well,
if it's
he wants it to happen.
He did come in.
I think I would have made the block first before moving the number 2 blitzer. Because if the block fails, you want the down lineman to stand up.
We did question the value of guard, did we? It might.
It's still an extra dodge. That was not the best way to get a 2 on the ball, I don't think.
Well, he doesn't need 2 on the ball. He's surfing.
Ah, very good.
Excellent play. Excellent play, I believe. Surf is up. And where does the ball go? This is important. This is really important. This can help elves, actually. Alright.
Not this particular scatter, though.
I cannot where did that ball go? That's insane. That's insane. That surf.
It was really good.
The surf was good. Like, he did what? He did a dodge. Well, he made it like...
It's a 3 plus 2 plus.
He did make it to be a 3 plus 2 plus. What did we have? We had like 3 plus. Yeah, but with what I was looking for, that would be a 1 dice, and that's bad. Yeah. This is obviously a lot better. I don't know. That angle kind of got me. Spartaco knows his stuff, it seems. Alright, so he does have quite a few more blocks. He has a free... Would you score this turn? Provided... Certainly not, right? Or...
As the Orc can stall. You've got a 2-man advantage. Stolen grind as the Orc.
So, yeah, pick the ball up. Do not like let the elf score. Just keep the ball. Let's grind them to turn 8.
Yep.
He has the positioning for it. Like a lot, 3 elves are on the left flank, and 4 elves are on the left flank. So, not looking good. But then again, we have seen a lot of weird matches, right? So everything can happen.
Absolutely.
I mean, have you seen the Wood Elf game? Like, we have casted it together, Nari and Janisi. That was insane.
I think the scariest part about that is now that he has potentially a reroll and the leader pickup. He's going to be terrifying, the full Wood Elf positional with 2 reroll. I don't know about this.
And the catch is bad.
Pick him up, 2-man advantage, grind him down. He's just throwing away a man advantage, and he's back to square one.
Out. It's not out. Yep. Alright, the scatter was ideal.
I don't like that play from the
Not ideal. Ideal would be 1 north, right? That would be an ideal scatter for him.
He shouldn't have done that play. That was ridiculous. Ridiculous. Mark the ball, the blitzer that received was meant to be the receiver.
I'm thinking about it.
No, not at all. Never.
I'm thinking about it. Like, he could... Like, if he... Like, yeah, but you had the ball. Why would you, like, try and give it? Like, grind him out.
He has a 2-man advantage. Scoring to reset
exactly,
that.
Exactly.
It seems crazy.
Well, he might be, you know, thinking, hey, I got this guy down to dead to rights. I want to score, and then I want SPP on a blitzer, right? I need to think about my next match. That could be a thing also.
True.
Like, if he got the handoff to that blitzer, right? And then if he scored in his drive on the same blitzer, he would have another skill for the next game. So whenever you can't score, it might be a good idea. Like, he stopped the elf scoring. He can do it again. Maybe. All right. I believe that was about almost the best carry you could wish for. The only better one would be, like, one to the west, right? Or onto the elf.
Yeah, well, out of a tackle zone off a corpse or something to that effect.
Yeah. How to protect the ball. He was not about to protect the ball. He was like, he wanted to score. Right, the witch. Let's pick it up. The ball is onto the witch, and look at that. There's a blitzer free down there, Fash.
Yeah, absolutely.
There's a blitzer free in
the
scoring
position. Punished for that grade, the orc.
Blue pack. Yeah, that greed might be really punished right about now. Even if that blitzer does not score, he is out. No orc can catch him. This looks really good for Lupak.
Yeah, absolutely.
Like, really good. The greed will most likely will get punished right about now.
Lupak could snake the pass and the catch. Anything's possible.
Anything is possible, correct. Alright. Dodge into a handoff. Even better. And, yeah, Lupak has it. Lupak has it. Look at that.
Unbelievable.
Actually, unbelievable. Definitely. Yes, I age, right? 10 years younger. I did think that too.
Wow!
So yeah, Lupex is safe right about now. He runs away, no one can catch him.
I mean, you can understand the temptations from the orc. You can understand the temptation of just scoring, sealing it out. Lupak then forced to score before turn 8, and then the orc stalls it out on his own drive. And look, he definitely wasn't going to get safe, but there were so many blocks he could have made on elves. And with the two-man advantage now being reduced to one.
Exactly. Yeah, that greed can, if Lupak ends winning the game, that greed play would be that.
Yeah, absolutely.
So, yeah. Hey, Tori, now you can join us in. Also, Sid saying, like, I have already committed a Dwarven act of shame. I'm kind of worried right about that. I haven't thought about that. Yeah, Lupak looks really good right about now, even with a guy down. He can stall for at least one more turn. Okay, now you can get a one. Now one is not that impactful. The handoff was big. Alright, so what's the Spartacus play? Who do you blitz? Loner or the Witch?
I think it's the Witch with block. I think you can angle to push her into the Black Orc.
AV7, why not? That greed play getting punished by the healthiest way possible.
Definitely need to threaten the boulder, force him to score.
Yeah, he needs to do that, yeah. He needs to force the score in the at least next two turns. But everything can fail. Like, the only safe action he has is that blitz. He doesn't have any blocks, so... That failed handoff really cost him, like, insanely. Pimplejam said he would get down and foul the Witch.
Nah, he does have a sub. But now, did Llama get surfed? Or does he have a sub line?
He does not have a. Oh, he does have a sub line. He does have a...
Yeah, looks like it.
Which gets fouled.
So he could think about it.
That would actually be not that bad.
Which coaches have an ammo.
Yeah, but, you know, you can drive that ammo out, and it's a risk. Everyone's saying how greedy that is, and I do completely agree with that. Greed to the max. But as I've said, I would also consider it. For the reasons I've stated, like, you know, getting the SPP, getting the elves down, and all of that is good stuff. But then again, then you start thinking, okay, what happens, like, the best quality you can have as a Blood Bowl player, Fash, correct me if I'm wrong, is... obviously roll sixes, but besides that, it's... think, what if this goes wrong? How can I make my position better if this goes wrong? If you always think like that in critical terms, I believe you will be a all-star Blood Bowl player.
It's a good idea, absolutely. Another thing to note is that the Orc, with the fewer blitzers and four Black Orcs, has a scarier 1 in 9 blocks. As an Orc, I'd be saving my rerolls for 1 in 9s. And needless agility 3 passing plays is not something I would attempt. Like when he 1 in 9 right. is his next block and he's down to 0, and then has to try and score, or wants to then score in 2, around turn 6 or 7 when Lupak runs it in, he's going to have no rules and might be punished for it further.
Alright, what did you do now? Just run it in? Risk the 2 dodges to tag the only blizzard who can get him? Like, screen off with, like, 2 elves? Risking a loner dodge? No way. He has to score, right?
It's still kind of early. The Orc still has a reroll in 4 turns.
He does not want to score. I know, he does not want to score, but does he have any other opportunity? Like, he has only one somewhat safe dodge, right? With the number 11 alignment. Because he can reroll that dodge. He cannot reroll the loner dodge. I mean, he can, but he can also fail. And the number 7 lineman up there has to do a 3+ first. So, and the ball is not safe wherever he goes.
The witch would come around to assist on the guard fella getting blocked by the number 11 lineman. And I think that might make it okay, as it's sort of a screen as well. So the risk is the 1 in 36 on the witch and the 1 in 6 on the number 11 lineman.
Right, then see the witch behind the black orc. You are correct, you are correct. Now with the advent of witch, yeah, he could... That will most likely be the best player right about now. Like, take the witch, assist the block, blitz with the number 11 lineman, and make a semblance of a screen, and just go to the sideline, I guess.
Yeah, look, I'd absolutely hide him in the corner. If no one can reach you, you're allowed to stand on the sideline.
I mean, he can't tag him. Like, worst comes to worst, he can't tag him. But no one can hit him. Now, I would say it's a toss between scoring and stalling. It is risky to stall. And, yep, he realizes that, and he wants to score. He wants to score however possible.
Might be fine, too. Look, he doesn't have a thrower, so the pickup...
Hey,
a 3+, second major reroll.
He cannot really be that dissatisfied with this. Like, he almost lost the game, right?
Yeah, absolutely.
So, I would count my blessing right about now and say, oof, literally. So, that's good. Alright, now he needs to defend against the 4. It's not that hard to defend against orcs and 4 turns. Worst comes to worst, he should be able to just, tag some of his guys, like give away a couple of blocks and stop their advance. He's only one guy down, not more.
Well, I think we might see why people start with a orc thrower until they've developed into a team with block. I think this blitzer might end up letting him down, the ball carrying blitzer.
Alright, we will see. Interestingly enough, like, where's the SPP on the orc team? Does he have? The SPP, a lot of it is on the blitzer, on the guard blitzer. Actually, all of it is on the guard blitzer. The orc team has grand total of 12 SPP, and 10 of those are on the guard blitzer. Interesting fact. Unless he has one on the line. Nope. And the thrower would definitely come in handy here because the thrower comes with a handy pass skill. Then again, throwers are so slow and they suck. AV8.
Yeah, look, it's more so for the short hands, I think. I wouldn't mind firing once they get to about 1400. Your Black Orcs have block. Your linemen have block.
Oh, right, the reroll can be huge.
Oh, definitely.
The reroll can be huge. Well, he didn't know where the ball will go. And he does have all of his blitzers in contact with the enemy. So that's all right. Like, all three of them will have block on block. Like, block on the guys. We should have done? We should have checked the blocks from the guard blitzer to see if Mighty Blow would remove a player.
Definitely. Wow.
Than that. It's not that late to start with that, right?
True.
He did get some use out of the guard. Or, no, he didn't actually get any use of the guard. He used the different players to free them up.
For the surf on the ball carrier, I think the guard was pretty useful.
Right, exactly. Right, so that, with a snake armor roll, no amount of mighty blow.
See the number 9 lineman? Number 9 lineman, I think, for the Orc could be where number 6 Black Orc is. Lou probably won't do it, but he could blitz down just a corner of the cage, just as, mild form of harassment. And on a Black Orc, that's a lot harder to do.
Stun, good. Yeah, just stop him a bit. Like, that is the weak spot of this cage right about. You could also blitz the Black Orc and tag the lineman with the loader. I kind of like a blitz and Black Horse if I can. If I can, like, not give away a lot of positioning in order to do so. Because if you get that lucky injury role, right, you want it to be on a black orc, not on a lineman.
I guess that's another rationale for sure.
I like blitzing black orcs. If I can do it without giving away too much of a positioning advantage, I will definitely do it. For instance, I believe that if he chooses just to stand up the lineman who dodged, right? I believe that the best choice would be to blitz the Black Orc, because he can use both of those players as a screen anyway. And he will also have two guys in the lineman. The only problem is that the guard can't come in. Oh no, the guard is irrelevant. Will he pick it up, Ash? I'd say no. I'd say he will have to use a reroll. I bet 50 fast points on that.
Oh, well, now the stakes are getting high.
I'm getting reckless.
I'm going to consult my lawyer. Make sure I've got the funds available.
Hey, there, Deacon.
Update from Penn Serverless. Matches tomorrow at 8:30 GMT.
Could you got a bit wrong with you. Tomorrow when?
At 8:30 PM GMT. Penn Server will have his rematch.
All right, that's after my match. He picked it up. I'm glad you didn't take my bet. So that will be after my match then. My match is what was it again? 7 GMT. He's 8:30. You say?
Indeed.
Alright, so, yeah, after my match. I don't know if I will be able to cast it, depending on how the match goes. My match goes.
You'll either be super happy or so sad you don't want to talk to anyone.
We'll see, can the orcs do it in 4 turns? That is the question now. If they, my beard, everyone is milling about the beard. Well, guys, it's hot. Kinda needed to do it. There should be another World Cup match after this one, right?
There is.
Do you have enough coffee for that one, too?
I have all the coffee. It's Morley and Arcturus at 8 p.m. GMT.
Right. Yeah, that's in an hour. All right, we'll have that one, too. After that, we need to play a game with Genesis, and how many dodge does Dark Elf have? Nope. Only Witch. No, Mighty Blow. I believe that Mighty Blow, well, so far the Mighty Blow wouldn't do anything. Guard paid off, in a manner of speaking. If the Orcs score here, it's going to be really tough for Dark Elves. However, if they don't score...
I think if they don't...
Elves can do.
Lu should definitely try to avoid overtime.
Definitely, yeah. He needs to plug that hole in the middle. I see a gaping hole in the middle. That needs to be plugged. One reroll.
Yeah, I think he's just so scared to dodge, he's leaving some base contact, like the lone alignment.
Right. No.
Maybe he's trying to bait out the 1-9.
Sure, we'll see. He needs to do a one-die block there. Then.
Gotta be careful, most one-die blocks are skulls.
Well, dodge, one-die, same shit. Actually, the one-die is vastly superior to dodge.
You reckon?
Three knockdown chances.
Yeah, but 5 skulls.
50%. We have 5 skulls to do. Okay. I don't know if I would actually reroll that. That's kind of big. That's kind of huge, in fact. I might have rerolled that.
Oh, it's so early, though. and you know there would maybe two yeah, other actions.
There's only two more turns, right? Check this out. Check this
It's gonna be huge games. You're Spartan, right.
Spartaco has huge amount of forward momentum with this play. I mean, could have. He could also roll bad. But like these two guys can be blitzed and hit off.
It's actually not that big unless he wants to do a handoff, as to get the assist for number 9 lineman, unless like the blitzer slides around the other side, there's going to be corpses in the way. And so the blitzer's going to lose four squares going horizontally.
He might do a handoff. Might see
another
handoff.
We saw how that worked out.
Failed two times, right?
You know, it might be worth it though, just for the gains.
It might be, yeah. This time, actually, it might be alright. The first foul is good. He got one corpse out of the way. And then the second one, and he can 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. He can have a cage behind him. I don't know. Well, even if he hands off, he ain't going anywhere. Like, if he hands off, he could set up on the left side of the pitch, but still there are no orcs to support him over there. But still, that's an open-sided pitch, but the elves can swing by again. The elves can swing by in the middle again. So what do you do if you're Spartaco? You don't hand off, that's for certain. That did not work for you.
Yeah, the handoff gain, I don't think it'll quite be enough, as I think the elves would screen it anyway.
Exactly, the elves can get to him anyway. Right, here comes the blitz. The blitz is not good. I mean, good enough for pushing, but no knockdowns. Thinking about it, he needs him down, right? He has 3 turns, 2 rerolls. No, still not. He was thinking about it. Now the problem is, the square where he would place his blitzer is not available anymore. Where does he go?
I think he might be thinking about go for it to stand southwest of the number 5 Black Orc, if this is a down, which it is.
Yeah, I believe that might be like he has a reroll for it. It's a decently safe play. Even if it fails, it's not that huge, because you have your orcs around it most likely. But before doing this block, right, if he was thinking of going on the left side, he should have moved these orcs. He should have transferred to the left side if he wanted to.
I also think number 10 lineman will run 3 squares in front of the guard blitzer as an attempt to screen off people trying to screen him off.
Exactly, like to purchase the land in the top left corner. And like he is one hand off away from, but now where the ball go? Where does the ball go? He uses that lineman to screen off. Lou has a shot at the ball.
Yeah, that's true. Maybe the blitzer was the screen in lieu of the lineman.
Unless, well, he will have a dice the ball. Like, even if he makes the cage exactly where he is right about now. Well, no, not really. If he moves, he has these linemen to create a screen for him. He is all right. Black Orc, so slow. So slow. Yep, the ball goes right about there. GFI not even needed. Not even needed. He's going to screen off the elf with the Black Orc and provide the assist. I will provide the assist. Every elf hit is a good elf. I like to hit elves. Not providing an assist, instead electing to tag a blitzer. Alright. I believe that was the better choice, especially that blitzer rolls a 1 of his dodge. Other than that, Spartaco looks to be in a really good position. That number 3 blitzer, aptly named Spartaco, is in a scoring position, like without GFIs, without anything, so Lupak needs to blitz that guy out. right? That guy needs to be blitzed off, which means that he cannot really go in the cage. And Sparky does have three more turns. Well, two more after this one, actually. Well, move the goddamn Black Orc. Sparkle, what are you doing? Move the Black Orc. He did not move the Black Orc. Alright, the lineman did go up, but he did not move the Black Orc. Why didn't he move the Black Orc? This Black Orc needed to be... He did move the Black Orc. Oh, he is... Oh, right, look at this fashion. What do you feel about this blade?
It's pretty tempting. Lou does like his serfs.
What do you feel about that play? I would not take it. This time, like, I'm really aggravated to say that, but I would not take it this time.
Where would you blitz instead?
I would go with 2-1 dice at the end of my turn. Fuck it.
Fair enough.
I would not allocate more elves to that. He did not elect to scream with the lineman. He instead elected to base with the lineman.
I believe. I like it. It's making things quite a nuisance for Lou.
He made a really good offensive effort. I'm liking the Spartaco play, to be honest. Like, he's safe, right? He has a forward momentum, something that you do not see with orcs. That, like, usually orcs do not get this far afield in one turn or two, right?
No, definitely not. They've made a lot of ground, and that blizzard is going to be hard to hit for two die. Not impossible, though. If the down number 6 lineman makes a 3+ to assist the number 11 lineman, it looks like he will not take the serf at all. And he'll make the 2-die block a blitzer that's on the ground to dodge to assist.
Oh,
and the witch will probably...
That's not good still. Yeah, he does have the... He does have... Why not follow that up and free the route for your witch? Like, if you were Spartaco, and you had that Spartaco blitzer up there free as it is, would you hand it off to him?
Yes, definitely. If he's unmarked, right. I'm handing off for sure.
So now a handoff is good.
Well, you're running out of time.
I know. You, like, even if that handoff fails, you still have another play in the next turn. So that's why you would like to score as soon as possible. Leaving
it depends what happens on Lou's turn, too. If his next dodge fails and he doesn't roll, the reroll fails, which it doesn't.
Exactly. I mean, that blitzer can still get blitzed and knocked down. And that's what Lou is doing. He is not down yet, but he is away from scoring, and he cannot score anymore, so that's good. Well, that was an obvious scoring threat now, but still there's a lot of space for these orcs to move through. The good thing about orcs right about now is they're slow. Like, he cannot create a really good cage in there. And the elves are making that harder with the screen. He can, like, block it off though. Oh man. It's getting tense, Fash. It is getting really, really tense here. If the orcs score, they're in a really good spot. Surely you're meant to reroll that.
I think he is. I think he's doing it, yep.
Oh, another 136. Oh, right.
Gotta be spewing. Right? Yep.
This one was not that critical, though, but still.
Yeah, it is and it isn't for sure.
Alright, so what do you do here? Like, you have two options, as the way I see it. Like, move through the number 2 blitzer, right, in the middle. Move through, screen the elves on the left, and, like, create a cage somewhere over there. Or, go on the right. Like, blitz the number 11 lineman smack in the middle of the pitch, like Bearded Oaf, right? And hit away the other lineman and go on the right side, because you have more orcs there. I believe that should be the play.
On the right looks good. One other option, which is the...
Right.
The dice option is you blitz away the one marking number 10 lineman, Rolex, hand off to Rolex, and I think he has a double go for it.
And then 2 die to score.
Similarly, I'm not sure if any elves they will. It could be a minimal screen, and Rolex wouldn't need to make the go for it till next turn.
I don't know, like, yeah, you could hand it off to him and score. Well, you know what the thing is, if he goes up there and he makes a single GFI, no one would be able to physically reach him. That's the thing.
Yeah, so that was the only temptation.
Right.
I mean, maybe number 11 rather than number 2. The house indeed. But just the most minimal screen would prevent those squares.
Exactly.
Like, I think the cage would be just safer.
Basically, wherever you put the north. If he likes to make a cage, let's see how he can do that. Like, he needs to blitz away the guy. Like, but what if the guy does not get down? That's the problem. If he doesn't get a POW, that guy's in the way.
He might blitz with the number 8 Black Orc then to push it towards your other men to get the follow-up. The follow-up center chain push to slide corpses out of the way, or
yes,
number 2 blitzer across.
He would need to hit from the angle which he cannot get unless he knocks down the number 9 line. If you want to do the chain push into your guy. Well, he seems to be going on the left side, or maybe not still.
Now the black one on the right indicates he wants to go to the right, I think.
Right. Right, so he can also... I would not trust in a dodge, though. Like, he needs to blitz the number 11, definitely. No dodges whatsoever. No, he goes on the right side, like that. Right, something completely different. Still good. He's going to be making a screen over there, but he cannot make that big of a progress, though. What is this, Fesh? What are we looking at?
No
idea.
This
is madness. This is
freeing up a blitzer.
Hand off to that guy? Or move that guy into scoring position to hand off next turn? One in nine chance to score is as good as any.
Yeah, it seemed a bit strange.
What is this madness? It does seem a bit strange. I mean, most likely he saw something that we didn't.
No, it's the right side. Maybe he's just trying to avoid the lineman having to make a block.
He still needs to do a GFI now. Or two of them with the ball. Well, two GFIs obviously preferable to anything else. And he has a screen, provided that this black orc just at least hits the line. Like, don't get 1 and 9, right? He doesn't. He pows it. He gets him out. So, the cage is good. Everything is good. And the only play Loopback has is a desperate cage dive.
I know, he really needs to stop one square from the blitzer. I think just the weakest of elf screens in front of him might be adequate.
He will be blitzed off. And he does not have movement enough to get that screen. He has two players in range of that. He can, like, he can only place two players, and he needs to cover a lot of ground. No, he cannot stop this. He can definitely not stop this. He has no players he can stop it, obviously, with a lot of bullshit dodges, but no, he cannot stop it. Like, this is the lineman and the witch can stop on the left, like, create a screen on the left, two guys over here, and he would need, no, he does not have enough players, simply as that. Oh, he gave him a surf. I do not agree with that. I definitely do not agree with that. I mean, actually, now that I think about it, check this out. He gets injured, right?
Does he get injured?
Lyman comes in. Yeah, he gets injured. No problem. Like, Lyman gets in. He has an extra lineman up there. So he's still with 11 players. And he uses up the action of the witch. With a half die, the witch at the end. No, this guy was on the floor at Maslow. You couldn't hear the blitz already. So, I don't know. Bullshit dodge, minus 2D on the ball carrier. Like, he needs to do only, what, 6 plus? No, that's a 5 plus, right? Can he make that better? He can, actually. Like, check this out. Loner goes out on a dodge, tags these two fellas. He runs in with the 5 plus and hits the blitzer. Because one dice, a push, would force him to do a handoff. Right? I believe that's the best option he has.
Well, he could do the same play then with a 2 plus, 4 plus, I think. The number 9 lineman's actually a square short. I was thinking something closer, like something different. You just man mark every orc. But now that you mentioned it, with just a push being enough, and still a double go for
two,
it as well.
Actually, two. You're correct with the number 9 lineman. That he needs 2, 2, and 4, right, to get 2, 4, 2 basically to get ahead in the ball. And this is 2 and a 5. So. Blitz the lineman on the bottom left to tag the ball carrier and then screen. He can't. Well, yeah, if he can tag the black orc, the blitzer holding the ball, then he can make a screen. Because he would need to use the blitz to free him up. Nope. Or you can get a skull. Skull is always fun. Alright, wow. So do you do any actions now, Ash?
No, that's right. I don't. I know a lot of coaches do.
Not in the World Cup. In a regular game, I would...
No, he made. It was the one that beat me in the Australian final. Just made every single block, all the time. In this sort of situation, turn 8, needs to score, made every block.
I mean, it is a 1 in 36 to actually fail the block, but yeah, so risky.
I'd have definitely taken that surf, though.
Where is the surf?
No, on the blitzer.
On the blitzer?
The witch elf on the blitzer.
Oh, definitely, he should have taken that. I completely agree with that. Like, the chances of him stopping the touchdown were slim. But then, you're all skull. Simple as that. Orcs are a hard opponent for fresh elves. But he does want to hit the witch, at least. And he does. That's it. Will he get rewarded for it? Like, risk versus reward. Killing the witch, always good.
Nah.
He does not get rewarded.
You don't. Not at all. Not with 2 go for it. So you need the reroll. If you double skull,
enable. I think would have done it. I don't hit elves. I don't like hitting elves. I always like hitting elves. But now, World Cup game, I would run it in. And I would most likely fail this.
Me
no,
too.
No. I would fail this. I fail my girlfriends. Dodge to the end zone, no problem. But go for it, bane of my existence. Alright, so one guy dead, so that's fun. And other than that, I believe that the orcs are in a really good position right about now. Like, really, really good. 2-1 grind coming up. For you guys that do not know what the 2-1 grind is, it's this, right? Score on your opponent's half when he receives, and then just grind them out. Grind them into nice little flowery paste, like all elves are supposed to be. I kind of would like to see a dead orc or two. What about you, Fash? Would like to see a dead orc?
It's improbable. Also, unless I'm completely mistaken, I think the 2-1 grind is that the opponent you score, whoever receives, is the favorite to win because of the 2-1 grind. And that is, whoever receives first scores in their own drive, and the opponent, to win, has to score quickly. They score quickly, and then you receive the ball again, and then you score. Therefore, the score is 2-1, and you've won because you received first. Like, to my knowledge, that was what the 2-1 grind was.
No, not really.
We should definitely Google that, as I.
Right. You, well, yeah. You receive, sure. You score at the end. Right. You're correct. You yeah. score at the end of your turn, right?
Yeah, absolutely. You score on turn 8.
He needs to score fast if he wants to. If he wants yeah. to win. But then again, your opponent can play for the overtime.
Yeah. Well, yes. Well, in the World Cup, yes. But in normal matches where there's no overtime.
Right, kick.
The 2-1 grind is the
shot at the ball. Kick is actually not bad. I think Lupak screwed up by not stalling one more play. Well, come on, Mac. From this perspective, it did, but who could have known? But that was too risky. But that play you fashioned, like, you saw it in, like, with the witch and the guy had hit him off, like, that would be a proper screen. He could have stalled one more.
Yeah, absolutely.
Then again, it was risky, but...
The blitzer catching it has been pretty big too. He only has 2 rerolls, yeah. Spartaco, and catching it saves him a big headache. He's really fortunate there.
And bam, straight off the bat, I would not like to be in Lupak's shoes right about now. I would be shaking. Both loners are out.
You know what he's saying.
One.
He's saying, oh, this is bullshit, I can't believe it. How has he got this guy off so early on my first block? It's just not fair.
Fair enough. I think that's what he would have said. Yeah, most likely he would. All right. Being 2 players down, it makes it really hard to stop the Orc Drive. Not impossible, but I do not believe Spartaco will give him many chances. Like, judging from the offense he mounted in the last 4 turns, Spartaco has a Lupak that writes.
Well, it's the snakes that have allowed that to happen.
The first snake, actually. The second was not that that huge.
But I mean, there's still, there are 2 or 3 actions. Like, the early turnover will always be capitalized on by any opponent.
Well, not always. Like, there will be a lot of Orc coaches who could not score from that position. Like, not that fast. He's now banging on the elves. Would you foul now?
No. You've got a 2-man advantage, anything else is just greed. Maybe on turn 8 with a sub.
I would foul if I had 4-man advantage, definitely.
Seems like you're just risking it.
3.
Turn 8 if you've got your sub on your bench still.
Yeah, but those are elves. 3 elves can ruin your day. 4.
And having 10 orcs can ruin your day, too. The foul risk is the same as being core-pommed. In a 30% send-off chance.
Fair enough. Yeah, fouling is kind of lackluster. Like, you don't want to be fouled. They need to give us a better skill for fouling.
Like, couldn't need fouls at all.
Player and sneaky get... Dirty player and sneaky gets should be baked in, both of them. At least. So, like, I can foul with a one dude. Oh, lineman blitz, look at that.
Might take the both down here. Final action, I don't see why not.
He might. But he still has a player there that's plugging the hole, right? That's why, maybe why not. And what Sid is saying, Lupak is definitely doomed. His best players are off the pitch. Let's see, how do you mount a defense here with 2 players less? That's why I don't know. Like, it's not that hard to score with elves against orcs, but how the fuck do you stop a competent orc coach who has 2 players up on you from scoring? We're about to see, boys. Because Lupa has to do it somehow, right?
Boys. I'd start by at least having 1 man threatening from the rear just to make sure that there's 5 men in the cage. If they've got 5 men on the cage, they've only got 6 men causing trouble. And so that's a good start.
Also, double serves as a scoring threat.
Yeah, absolutely.
But then again, you are wasting one of your guys.
Not if it's dictating that he has to then form a cage properly.
Well... Oftentimes, what happens if you just send a guy down willy-nilly is that the opponent is just going to run away from him, like run away somewhere where that guy is not relevant.
As an elf,
because
that moves
opening up space.
Moves enough. I think that's okay. I wouldn't do it as a dwarf or a orc.
But yeah, enough, I think it's okay. Don't put dwarves in the back. Then elves, especially wood elves. Those guys are fast. Think about it, wood elves are akin to rats. Alright, here comes the blitz. One dice block, it's good. He could really use a removal there. Did the guard guy hit? He did, didn't he? But didn't check if Mighty Blow would do anything.
Ah, I completely forgot.
I forgot too. Our fault. We'll try to be... Oh, that's a skull! That's something you can't really reroll. And...
Didn't I tell you all one that box of skulls?
Well, Lupak definitely seems to be taking that mantra. All one dice blocks are skulls. Not good. Not good for Lupak. Not at all.
A lot of base contact.
A lot of base, yeah. Well, that's what he has to do right about now. If he wants to stop the orc's core, he has to. And he has to pray that his armor holds. He's incurring a lot of blocks, yes. But all of those blocks, or a couple of those, are safe.
I mean, the other option for Lou, it would just be really solid screening. We saw how he moved on the left flank, the number 8 lineman, just up one square. It's because one square matters. By downing the number 7 Black Orc in the cage, he's really preventing forward movement. And so if he can do that sort of thing safely without giving a lot of blocks in return, just thwarting the dwarves' the orc's movement might be enough. And in the overtime, a chance to receive. That could be his other method of playing.
Well, the thing is, he is not stopping them. He's incurring, how many, like 3 blocks right about now, maybe even 4. And that's not really safe.
No, I mean, instead of committing to making blocks, just, you know, screening
right,
and making
right,
the key
right.
block.
Yeah, I believe that could have been the... Well, at some point he needs to do this. He needs to tag all of them orcs and stop them from moving around. Like, trust in their dodges. And at one point he needs to do exactly that. Alright, so far so good. Come on, let's see the block. Let's see the armor rolls. He wanted a guy. Okay, no mighty blow required. No mighty blow required. Guard still better choice. I believe that he... Well, now we can definitely say that the guard was the prime choice. Ooh, would you apple this, Fash? Interesting choice.
I guess he's confident that he'll be able to stop the drive.
Seems so. I would maybe save it for the knock.
Save it for a KO, yeah.
Well, not knock them. KO, yeah. Save it for a KO.
I don't think he has a chance unless he gets it to overtime. And then it's a 50-50.
Yeah.
Have the Orc 1 in 9 just twice. He's out of rerolls.
Alright,
there it is.
That's kind of big. But he rerolls it. Rerolls it like a champ there. That could be a huge upset if that was an 1 in 81. Oh my god, the elves are just... The elves are just exploding right about now. Why didn't he stand up that black orc, like, ages ago?
I think he wants to blitz with it.
That's why. He wants to blitz with him. He really forgot that, he still had a blitz. Fair enough. Blitzing is good. That's a good name move. Hey, Dragon Slayer. How are you? And that's another 2-dice block. Into another 2-dice block. Oh, that would be... I would take that as the last block of the of the turn, right?
Yeah, absolutely.
I would like to take that vote out. Minor. All right, let's jump on the we hate Spartacus because he plays bad bandwagon. That's a clear and obvious mistake there, right?
Well, yeah, I guess so. I mean, I have a claw upon beastman with that block, and I always use that last. Just so I can take both downs. Yeah. It's the same logical to play, I think.
Like, three guys stunned and one guy injured, all in a single turn. Like, he has been punished, like, over the top punished, I believe, for the basing. Like, when you base a lot of the orcs with your elves, you dread, like, seriously, you're afraid of this happening.
Definitely, and AV8 elves shouldn't be stunned that frequently, or shouldn't have armor broken that frequently.
That push on which elf gave more 2 dice block with block? No, it didn't. No, it didn't. This guy would have... Was it irrelevant with this? Completely irrelevant. Right? Push. Oh no, actually, he is correct. Like, that push made it for another 2 dice. Alright. He has grand total of 5 elves able to do something, Vash. How is he going to stop the orc?
He's not at all.
Running through. Looks bad.
I guess maybe just the generic off screen directly in front of it, just to try and limit the movement somewhat.
I really hope I do not lose this many players, because I believe that the death that was in the lineman would kill a dwarf. Any of these we had only one of both of these stuns would knock down an orc too. One of them wouldn't though. Yes, 3 stuns and an injury on an armor value 8. I often do not do it that much in armor or armor value 7.
We're seeing a dodge. We're seeing a dodge. It's a dive. It's coming. 1 die power. You ready?
No, certainly not.
It's happening.
Certainly that cannot happen. No, it's not. No, it's not. He is not going in there.
He's doing it.
He is not that crazy.
He's 100% doing it.
No, Fash. I believe you must be mistaken. There is not much to be gained from that. He has 3 elves on the floor.
He's going to pallet for a death. I'm feeling it.
All right, let's see. Let's see then.
Blue luck, you ready?
It could happen. It could happen. I have seen Lou pull off some crazy shit, so... The thing is, even if he does power, he needs to kill him, yeah, for it to be worth it, like...
I look on the ground.
And? Nope.
Oh, fair enough.
Alright, not a death, but...
A stun is not a death.
A stun is not a death. Definitely. Right, well, now he's in a good position. Now he can defend. Until the orc end their turn. Imagine if Spartacus would be a good guy and just press enter, right?
That'd be a madman, not a good guy at all.
Will you count that as collusion if it happened?
Who knows? I'd probably just restart the match. That seems to be the popular trend these days.
Fair enough. I'm actually glad there are more good and honest people in this world who would say fuck the rules, restart the match. Don't.
That's a good and honest. That's silly. It's silly.
Huh?
I think it's madness.
Not silly. The match.
If I was Observer, I'd be outraged. I'd be so outraged. It's such a great start.
Oh, I would definitely. I would be outraged too. But
stuns the extra rule on the kickoff. Like it was all smooth sailing.
It was, but you know, the game was not decided definitely. So I would go for a restart in that case. For example, in this case, Lou disconnects. Restart. Yeah, right. Yeah, fucking right.
What do you mean the score's 1-1? Seems fair.
Yeah, but you know what I mean. Common sense. Let's see that guard hit. So far, Mighty Blow would have been useless. And guard really came in a couple of times. He obviously needs more time to tank crash.
Yeah, it is a bit odd. I mean, if I ever one day have the diligence to plan my moves before actually doing them in a game of Blood Bowl, it would be a immediate action. I guess it's, you know, what if it's a push? That could be the consideration. And then now that it's a power, let's stay to assist.
Please, the elves are not breaking right about that. But the orcs cannot really move that far either. I mean, not that they need to, but
I think it'd be a pretty good cage to the northeast of the number 6 Black Orc. The linemen have it covered.
Yeah, definitely. Yeah, he has a 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Definitely has a cage in. But can the witch do something about, like? Yeah, she can. She can do like a 3+, 2+, and get in from either side. But yeah, he has two more blitzers on the left that he can use to plug the hole with. So the cage on the right is perfectly safe right about now.
Yeah.
And he is doing it. He now needs to move the ball, obviously, first before the. I would fuck that up, right? No, actually, I do believe that even I could not fuck that up. Where did I lose the game for that? Or I almost lost the game, can't remember. I did fuck up like cage building, and I had to make an extra GFI, right? And of course I failed that extra GFI, rerolled it, and then I had to dodge with my ball carrier, which I also won. Thus losing me the game. The cage is being set up. Why not go even further, Pash? Why stick down there?
Considering that now, it does seem a bit odd that he stopped short. He had these squares to protect it.
The only reason I can see is... Alright, check this out, reasoning. Like, he, up there, his cage corner would have been a measly lineman. Lowly lineman.
Yeah. But
now he has a black orc on that corner, and a blitzer on the other corner. So he blitzed all of the other corners. So all of the corners are as safe as they can be. How would you rank the skills, Fash? Would you rank it block being the best one and guard being the second best? Or would the dodge be the second?
Block then dodge, yeah.
Block then dodge, then guard.
Yeah, I'd say so. I mean, it depends on which team you play too. A guard and a bash team, much more handy than a guard and an elf team, but still handy on an elf team.
I kind of disagree there. Guard and elf team is a lot more handy than guard and a bash team.
You reckon? What about when you're playing other bash teams?
Absolutely.
As your bash team? What happens when your dwarves
Absolutely.
Face up against chaos or orcs?
No, check this out. Like, let's say we can give two guards to a bash team and two guards to an elven team. It's more valuable to an elven team, right? Than it is to the bash team.
If they're playing each other.
It doesn't matter. Playing whatever.
An orc with two guards against a lizardman. Or a dwarf with two guards against a lizardman. Not
right.
Super impressive.
Not super impressive, exactly. Elf with two guards against Lizard.
Elf with two dodge.
or guard.
Pretty handy. I mean, they're all situational. Yeah. Every skill is. I mean, we have to rank them arbitrarily.
But how I look at it is that when I'm playing like elves, right? Every guard is like, oh my god, this is amazing. And when I'm playing like any other bash team, like, yeah, I do need that guard. And that's how I rank it. Like, if it's amazing or all right, I'll take it. The elves have gotten the orcs in the corner. I think they have them where they want them, Bash.
Well, kind of. He's touching a black orc, a blitz after the black orc makes the block. And he's midfield in a fairly decisive cage. I think Lou's dodges will have to fix that.
We'll see. He does have a reroll up on Spartak.
Yeah, but I don't think he'll use it.
Lexel, what you want to have is usually you want to start up with all four blitzers on the orc team. Like, that is the best start for new coaches, I believe. That is the best start to the game. Four blitzers, I believe three black orcs, right? And do you have to take a goblin in there somewhere?
Never a goblin. That's always a. I personally prefer the four black orcs, three blitzers, buy into a blitzer. And the rationale is that you have the Black Orcs from the start at a so they can get blocked quicker through SVP generation or MVPs, and the Blitzer you can just buy into and level up willy-nilly. It's hard to level a Black Orc, so I prefer to start with it. That's for perpetual leagues, but in a knockout, the Blitzers are better. In a World Cup knockout format, the Blitzers
are better players, to be honest. Blitzers are better players. The only problem with the Black Orcs is they're so hard to level up, and landing an MVP on them is huge. And you only have four, more likely to land the MVP on. But Blitzers are the better players, in my opinion.
Anyone with blocks is fantastic.
Like, would you swap those four Black Orcs for four more Blitzers?
You're kind of just then a dwarf then, aren't you? A slightly more agile dwarf.
Yeah, slightly more agile and fast dwarf. Yeah, you would have eight block pieces from the start, and all of them block pieces. Yeah, slightly more agile dwarf, which is not that bad though.
I think I would.
Dwarves do it. Yeah, I think I would too now when I think about it. Like, more agile dwarf does sound good. More agile and fast dwarf. Does sound good. Oh, Lexel, no. Two blitzers, two black orcs, two throwers, goblin, and a six lineman is a horrible start team. Sorry, but it is. Check out the four blitzers. Fuck, four blitzers, four black orcs even. Like, you can go with one reroll if you want. But no, four blitzers, three black orcs, and like, for a starting coach, Fash, for a new coach. Four blitzers, obviously better than four black orcs, right?
No, look, I think the new coach might prefer the Black Orc as the crutch of force strength. Just being able to make a block immediately. I think they would prefer that.
I like
either's fine. Like, you, it's
yeah, both of them are fine. So, the elves are not... Well, the orc coach is not rushing anymore. I would do about the same. I would hit the elves, right? And that's what he's doing.
No, yeah, absolutely.
Not rushing anywhere, just hitting the elves and trying to, you know, reduce their numbers even further.
I mean, you definitely would prefer your cage to be in a scoring position, just chilling and waiting for the turn to tick over.
Exactly. That's ideal. But he does have four more turns to get to there. Well, three after this one. Actually, what? Okay. There it is. Well, he is obviously going to take that. No stunts forthcoming anywhere. And yeah, what Ed is saying. Four Black Orc, four Blitzers, a Gobble, three rerolls. That's how I go with my orcs. I do not buy a thrower because I don't like it. Don't like the thrower. And the first actual team patch that I played with orcs had the first Blitzer rolling agility on it. I never looked back.
You've been spoiled.
I never look back.
That's the dream.
Yes.
I keep the throw until that happens, or until I have it block on everyone to be able to afford to reroll
Booklets of failed pickup. Even if that didn't happen, I would take sure hands on the guy. Like, straight up, take first level sure hands. I don't want the freaking thrower. 8 armor, I like the pass is good. Like, the passes are a really good, backup plan. I have been foiled many a time with the orc passing play. I know. I like the blitzer carrying the ball. I hate the because movement 5 is. I hate movement 6, but 5 is.
You know, it might be kind of tempting to surf number 2 blitzer. It'll be some dice and a little bit of a commitment.
Well, not that big of a commitment, though.
Yeah, I can get a 1 into a 2 fairly easily.
Like, for example, he could dodge out the number 6 lineman on the floor, right? Number 6, dodge out the number 6 lineman on the floor, two dice the number 9 lineman orc, thus tagging the black orc, and then just surf the other guy, like surf the blitz.
2 into a 1. Because of the ball carrier assist.
Exactly.
And we'll give these squares right, for the witch to retreat, and also then provide a little bit of a screen.
But you are kind of, well, maybe not forced into this, but how are you going to defend otherwise?
Taking a blitz out, I think, would be worth it.
Could be. Alright, he is doing it. He seems to be doing exactly that.
We should turn on the lay bucky. No, I'm sure Lee saw that from the start.
No, Lou is not looking at it. Right, but why not? He does not want to serve them.
Wow.
Because he did not follow up. Because now that becomes a 1 into 1. Without block.
That's weird. It's a 1 into
red. It is.
One
it
into
is.
Red,
and he is not giving away a hit. 1 into red. No, into 1, yeah. Okay. 1 into 1.
Yeah.
Well, red into 1 is this stands right about. No, 1. Sorry. Yeah. 1 into 1. That's, well, not...
Should have followed. Definitely should have followed. 2 into 1's a lot safer.
Yeah.
Doesn't want to burn a reroll on it.
Even if you get a freaking POW, like boat POW in there, you still have an exit strategy.
Yeah.
Alright, here comes 1 into 1. He has to risk something. Alright, there's a POW. He's obviously not rerolling the freaking POW. But he ain't doing much either. The witch, like, need to get the hell out of dodge.
He might even dodge out of dodge.
He will dodge out of dodge. Alright. Lou still has him where he wants it. I firmly believe that. Believe in that. These black orcs are going to roll a 1 in 81. Mark my words.
There's a 50% chance of it happening.
So, I will be right back.
I'll wait here. I guess look at Harry, and for the entire half he's just saying, wow, I don't know how he's going to do it. But really, Nuffleton just decided instantly. I'm sure everyone watching has had a 1 in 81 on their first action on a 2-die block. Things you can do to mitigate that would be taking the safer place first, which would be the Blitzer 2-die with the guard assist on the south side of the cage. And he does take it. And that was the 1 in 81, so... he's got that out of the way. It is now less probable that that exact dice happens again, but not less possible. Less probable. There you go, an extra incentive to make you safer plays first. And I think just due to that predicament, he might be making this one to have the ball carrier rotate and move somewhere else. Perhaps. Maybe not, though. I mean, getting out of the corner is definitely desirable. It'll make it harder for Lou to screen. But he just doesn't really go anywhere safely. He got on one side.
Still winning the game, I see.
Line on the other. Yeah, look, he I was talking about making safe plays first, and he made a block with the blitzer to the south of the ball carrier, or the south of the cage, and it was a 1-9. Okay. But the blitzer, of course, had blocked.
Definitely, yeah, safe plays first, so... So now, do you move your cage onto the left? Like, use this black work as a cage post?
If he does, it's a single go for with a lineman.
No, why would it be?
A number 11 lineman. If he wants to complete the cage.
No, he can use the blitzer. He can use the blitzer.
Sure.
The guard blitzer, right?
He's only got threes, bare men's.
No, he hasn't. He has the cage. The number 9 lineman goes to the left, like spot, like left of the black work down. Yeah. Then the black work goes at the top, and then the guard blitzer goes in
the black hawk marks by the witch.
That's it.
Black hawk's not making
that
dodge.
Black work is marked by the witch.
You crazy,
didn't
son.
Didn't even see the witch. I was like, yeah, that black work is free. The witch is sneaky.
Yeah, so single go for with number 11
how,
line.
That's how, like... Then, that's alright. He didn't blitz yet, eh? He
Correct.
Could use the black orc to blitz the witch. Now he would still need a go for it, then. So, yeah. Single go for it with lineman sound best. Or, like, free up a black orc.
Or maybe number 10 lineman does the blitz.
Well, now he doesn't, 1, 2, 3, 4, now he doesn't need, like, now this blitzer can go down, and the black orc who he just freed can go up there. And he has the perfect agent.
Looks good, now it's a safe block with block as well.
Witch. I would lose the game on dodging by virtue of not seeing the witch. It's like, she's so far away from, like, the others. I don't know how to explain it, but I didn't see her. Right. You get wrestle on linos. Not Nork ones, no. Not Nork ones. 5 movement sucks. Fash, we need to see a huge ball hawking play. Like, we need to see a sack where Lupac is not going to work.
I think so. I think he will be saving a roll for it later. There's no tackle on the Orc team, it'll come from the Witch. If it's still alive.
Me not seeing things might be my downfall. Then again, I have that buffer of luck for not seeing things. Yeah. So that's kind of cool. But we have seen 2 misclicks so far, right?
Oh, like, man, the Orc last night. That was huge. His first action, 6 plus dodge.
Exactly. Like.
And he won that game.
The Dwarf made it, like, right? The Dwarf made, like, Dwarf made the 6 plus dodge.
Yeah, the Dwarf too, absolutely. From the non-screening Dark Elf.
Exactly, completely irrelevant too. Ash, you still in there?
Yes.
Alright, something happened. Like, you just went out.
Oh, we covered the Dark Elf that didn't screen the Dwarf and the Orc that made the immediate 6 plus. The Orc that made the 6 plus?
Right,
yeah.
Right. The Orc failed the 6 plus, though, but...
He did. The first action, though. Yeah. And then won that game. Couldn't
first
believe it.
Action, yeah. And then won the game, yeah. Unbelievable. This game does not look still anyone's game, but more anyone, more Sparticles anyone than Lootbacks.
Yeah. He is someone as opposed to no one. Velimogulus.
Yes. So what's the next game? Arcturus, was that a dwarf? I mean, it's safe to assume that he's a dwarf, there's so many dwarves.
Absolutely.
Best chance of assuming, yeah. Lupak is trying his hardest, but the orcs just have three more players more, and they're not stupid.
And look, it's only three players. While it does have an effect, it's not outrageous. Like, elf coaches should be used to playing down elves. I think this is the dodge.
I completely disagree with that, Fesh. Yes, if we're talking about 1600, 1700 Dark Elf teams, yes. But fresh Dark Elf teams, no, you do not play with three players down. You cannot play with that. Yes, you cannot play with three players down in the fresh teams league. You cannot get used to that because that's hard and harsh and almost not doable. Against competent opponents, again. Are we looking at a cage dive? He does. This is the perfect situation. He does have the blitzer down there. He goes. He goes. The witch elf does not go in. He snaked that.
He did.
He snaked that. Third one. So by that reckoning, the orc now needs to roll three snake eyes. A quad skull would be preferable to start the first turn with, right? I believe that would be preferable right about now. Like, Lupak had this decently planned, to be honest. Like, check this out. He knocks the ball out, right? The ball is out. He gets a pow, the ball is out. The number 8 lineman picks the ball up, hits it to the number 2 blitzer, he's up. He scores, he wins the game. Like, that could have happened. Like, easily.
5+5+, favorable scatter.
That could have happened easily. When I say easily, I meant easily. Well, not that easy, but compared to everything else, easy. Mighty Blow? Hey, Mighty Blow would have done the thing here. Mighty Blow would have broke armor. I believe he got the mileage out of the guards. He got a lot of mileage out of it. Guard or block, better to wrestle, definitely. In most situations. The only time I would take wrestle is on an elven team of some sort. And if I know I'm playing orcs or dwarves. That's when I would like to have wrestle instead of block. And also, wrestle is good for ball hawks. Mighty Blow does not break armor. It absolutely does, Dragon Slayer. It absolutely does help you to break armor. Either or. Well, yeah, either or. If you use it to break armor, you don't use it for injury. If you don't need it to break armor, you use it on the injury roll. That's how Mighty Blow works. Looking bad now. Well, the witch can still do it. He still has. I believe that. I would cover the blitzer down there.
The guard blitzer's in a good position. Make the witch have to take extra squares.
Yeah, that's all right. But this blitzer, number 2 blitzer that Lupa has down there, that elf is really dangerous. Like, really dangerous. He needs a guy in there. Somehow. He needs a guy on him. But what I would do is send this. Send the Black Orc up there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Nope. Send the Black Orc down there. Nope, still not good. Alright, so check this out. What I would do right about now is. Can't do it. I cannot do it. These two Black Orcs and a Blitzer are a really unfortunate position right about now. Oh, you can. Like, check this out. Number 2 blitzer. They're all right on the right flank. to the top of number one Dark Elf Blitzer. Then do after doing a two dice up there, do a one dice on the down guy and mark the number two Blitzer. And mark the number two Blitzer. That's the receiving threat. If that guy receives the ball, Lupak won the game. I do not believe I would left him untagged. Pash, have you died yet?
No, that seems alright. He has used his blitz though.
No. He didn't need to blitz. He just needed like one die on the number seven lineman, right? And then tag the. All right. Well, obviously that would fail because he would fail the roll here. So yeah. All right. Well, not a dub skull, but as close to it. And you know what? Like Spartaco having this happen right about now is about the best time it can happen to, if it had to happen.
Yeah, absolutely. Lou can still attempt the crazy dive and attempt to lob it to the number two blitzer that you're worried about.
He can. The number two blitzer is a danger. The orc needed to try and get the mark on it.
Would you say it would be the easiest 5 plus of his life?
Well, no, it's a lot. Now the problem is the guard guy is positioned extremely well.
Well, no, you go from the top. You don't red die. So it's a single go for it for the initial hit.
Yeah, single go for it. Yeah, single go for it. Yep, all right. Couple of go for it. Two of them with dodges. One of them with a dodge. She goes. No dodge used. And she goes down. And that would be the end of that elf.
Yeah,
well, stunned.
Yeah.
Still not bad. Still not that bad.
It was a snake again.
Unbelievable.
Does he remember his last game? The witch had three. Now the witches had two. I mean, they were crazy actions. You wouldn't expect them to work.
Yeah, crazy actions nonetheless, but yeah, having
ones are still novel.
But to be completely honest, like, you can't blame snakes this time.
Sure.
The first one you can, definitely. The first one, actually, you cannot blame the first one either, because he recovered with the 1-9 failure, right?
Nah, it's bygones.
Yeah, a stun here. Yeah, stun here. He will not have the witch for the turn that matters the most. He needs to do a crazy one turn touchdown. He needs a riot. Lupak can still win.
I gotta go and score this turn, and maybe just he dodged him with a blitzer. Just roll a five. Roll a five plus for the stumble or power.
He ain't scoring this turn. That's definitely. But yeah, he can dodge him with a blitzer unless he gets killed right about now. Now the question becomes this. Do you use your blitzer, your guard blitzer, to hit off the lineman? Or do not use him and use him in the creation of the cage because you know that your opponent is going to try and dive in the next one?
Yeah, look, I make the block with the block guy, with the guard fella, and just take the cage two squares to the right.
So,
and then think about dealing with the number... Then think about dealing with a lineman. Only blitzer, yeah. But no risk, absolutely no risk when you don't need to. And standing people up before making that play.
Those people are not relevant right about now. Like, those blocks, all of those blocks are completely irrelevant. Well, not
They should be standing there. Nobody Black Hawk should be standing and assist, pretending to assist.
Black
Hawk, relevant.
Yeah, I agree. He could pretend to assist. I agree completely with that. He should have done that first. But he is thinking in the matter of relevant plays right about now. He wants to have the best position possible. Like he's calculating his opponent's moves and what he can do. Because that blitzer down there is still a threat. Like, that blitzer can literally win the game. He needs to make the cage as far to the right as possible. so that this blitzer and screen off the blitzer. I don't know why he's thinking that much. It doesn't look like. Count square, make the cage, go for it. He wants to make the best cage possible. He wants to make the cage out of titanium, I guess.
Well, the guard in one corner, and maybe even the third man on one of these four sides of the cage, just so if a dodge does come through, it's red as opposed to a one die.
Exactly. Well, he can avoid the guard, though. If the guard stays in the same position, he can come up. I mean, this blitzer can actually be powed. If the blitzer gets powed, it's over, more or less. If both of them get powed, it's over. He is certain taking his time. Only a minute has passed, Fash. Why does it feel like that this turn has lasted for... Yeah, it seems like a long freaking minute.
It might have been 1 minute PST. Which is, of course, a different time zone.
Fair enough. I have decided that I'm going to use, like, GMT for most of my time zone crap.
It seems like a rational thing to do.
Yeah, use the freaking GMT. I mean, most ideally, had a disconnect, all right? Had a disconnect.
Not to restart the match.
Imagine Lupak winning this and disconnect. Like restarting the match and Lupak winning. Imagine that. I would not put it behind him, to be honest. I would not put it past the light. Like, Spartaco needs to win now before his internet gives up.
Maybe. I think, like, Blitzer dodges in into this weaker cage, powers the ball carrier, and our ball carrier recovers, but fails to pick up. That could definitely be a thing. Well, I don't think Lou's scoring. I think it's still going to overtime.
Yeah, right about now, he needs to get them down, and then for Sparky to fail the pickup, and that's about it. Right, the cage is secure, more or less. It's not that secure, though. It's not secure at all. So he does block with the black mark. He wants the guard to protect his ball carrier.
Yeah, that makes sense.
This is just irrelevant, almost. But the KO'd elf is a good elf. Right. So where do you put your guard? Your guard guy? Right in front of the blitzer?
Yeah, I think so.
Cover the most squares, but why there?
Well, because you know that the blitzer on the left is a threat, and you know that the number 9 lineman...
He has a screen down there.
And number 9 lineman dodges out on a push from the number 11, or no action from the number 11, into a double go for it, unmarked as well. Double go for it touching the ball carrier.
Now Elzer Breaker. No, why are you giving him more SPP? Bad lineman. That's SPP on an orc. Well, that's his first SPP. But that makes him eligible to get an MVP level up. And these guys can fight Sam or Guinness, so if they win. So I kind of would not like them to have MVPs. So, what are we looking at? 1-81 now in the lineman. Lineman jumping in and killing the ball carrier.
Well, no, with the guard north of the blitz, it's so red. Or a 5 plus. 1. So he's either coming from the south and avoiding the guard, or adjacent the guard. I think I would be avoiding the guard and just taking a slightly harder dodge.
Yeah, I would be avoiding the guard too. So, alright, so what are we looking at now? Couple of dodges. Two dodges to tag him and go from the bottom side to pin him off. Right?
Yep.
Number 6 lineman tags him, number 9 lineman tags the black orc. Both of them are tagged, and the number 3 blitzer gets in from the bottom while taking a 5 plus dodge into a 1 die. So I believe that's all Lupak can do. But there is no one else to pick the ball up.
Nope, so you're relying on AFL pickup. You could have the richest tee to a scoring position, or he could attempt a 2+ double go for it to maybe think about picking it up. If it lands in the hands of the catcher, you follow the block, lands in your hands, it fumbles, lands in the number 2 blitzer's hands, it fumbles, and it lands towards where the R is in the middle. Then the richest tee blitzer picks it up.
Right.
But that is somewhat improbable.
Well, yeah, but still, no, he cannot score, and that's, yeah, he can pick it up and pass it somewhere. I agree.
Well, with that improbable play in mind, though, could send number Scabumonte, number 7, down the...
That's a lot of Bucky scatters, though. And we don't see a Bucky in the game. Have you seen the scatter? The Bucky scatter?
I've seen the Bucky scatters. Your final Twitch Bubble League match. That was incredible.
Exactly. My final Blood Bowl Tactics League match. That is the Bucky scatter.
That poor Dark Elf. You got to feel for him. He really planned for it. Dark Elf everywhere.
I did feel for him, and there my dick side, which said fuck him, came into view. But I did feel for the guy. Yeah, the hope, Lexel, now the hope is that he forces the overturn. He needs to make an additional dodge, and then come in from this angle to hit the blitzer, and that's it. One dice pow, casually, into a failed pickup. He wins the game. Well, he wins the game. He goes into overtime where he can receive and win the game. Will it happen, Fash?
50-50? 50-50. I mean, most games that I see Lou play, he's pretty lucky too. He's usually the one that's up on cash. In fact, I've never seen a game that he's played where he's been down men.
Now you do.
Yeah, exactly.
Now you do.
I think he was up man on his last opponent, too. He had three cash on the dwarf.
He inflicted 3 cash or lost?
Inflicted 3 on a dwarf for
That's how you win 2. Against dwarves.
Yeah.
That's how you win against dwarves.
But now being down man, it's proving a lot to be much difficult for him. Much more difficult.
Alright, well, the thing is, he saved both rerolls. Funnily enough.
We're gonna see him use this turn.
Most likely, he would not want to use it on the dodge, definitely. But he will have to.
It's gonna sting.
He will have to. Alright. Bam! That's it.
Well, you know, we did see the dwarf in the overtime do something crazy. Will this orc do something crazy?
Alright, so move the guy out of the way, score, do not do anything else.
That's the correct play.
Exactly. Move the guy out of the way, score, end.
Yep.
End.
But we've seen a lot of people do some greedy things. Well, not a lot, but a few.
Move the guy out of the way. Do not risk a... Would that be a Hexaskull?
No, you don't even make blocks.
Have
don't roll any dice.
Have you ever seen any of them?
They're probably just having a chat in chat.
Yeah. And that's it. Bam. Alright. That's it. He has...